Close your eyes anymore when I kiss your lips. There's no tenderness like before in your fingertips. You're trying hard not to show it. For you, girl, you were starting to criticize every little thing that I do. It makes me just feel like crying.
nights in white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send. Beauty I'd always miss with these eyes before. Just what the truth is, I can't say anymore.
Hey,
can you hear me?
I can hear you.
I'm almost, oh good, I'm almost there. I'm not here yet. Okay. I just ran to see where the provider's name is. Let's see. Oops, hold on. Okay, so it looks like the, I'll be back.
Your Elvis is playing.
Can understand me. Oh, we got a little Elvis. I'm looking. Can you hear me okay? Yeah.
Okay.
There we go. I'm looking at a pill bottle to see exactly what the name is. Have you seen those bottles yet?
The what?
Have you seen the bottles, the pill bottle pictures?
Special K just sent the pictures to you. She sent them to you. She said in chat. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to blow them up, but I've seen them. That's what it looks like to me.
There we go. Phew. Okay.
Okay.
I was staring at the pictures the Special K just sent me.
Uh-huh.
And then I looked. I blew them up as big as I could. Let me do it again here.
Okay.
There it is.
It's interesting, I'll say that.
See, I don't see. I don't know. Let me look here.
It's kind of hard to see, and you have to look. I don't even know how to explain it to you. It's hard to see, though.
Okay, yes. Special K, I got the pictures, and I have them blown up all the way. Special K says, I can't see either, but can kind of make out.
It's blurry, but I can make it out. It was blurry, but I can make it out. It looked like this.
The bottom right. Okay, let's see. Bottom right. How do I turn this sideways?
Or deep, so like me. Yeah. It's really blurry, but you can make it out, I'm telling you. You have to really concentrate, but you can get there.
I see where it says take one. It looks like take one tablet. By mouth, right?
Mm-hmm. But it should be in that right hand corner.
Why the heck is her name Shannann?
I don't know.
I wonder if she had to have a different name so that it didn't trigger.
Mm-hmm. What they had on her, like, you mean like those alerts? Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, remember how Cindy Wild said that she was known as a seeker?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, they do that here too. Like, yeah. Mm-hmm. They'll tag you.
So just changing, yeah, just changing.
Now they go
the
by your driver's license. Yep. So they, yep. Your picture.
Someone, what? Mm-hmm. I emailed the state police in Wisconsin when he posted the one lady's picture and her whereabouts. Who are you talking about? Is it Talisa? Talisa? Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
Bloody hell, storm mom. Special day.
So you could see it, storm mama?
Yeah, it's really blurry, but it looks like that D to me. Yes. I can make out the D and the Z. And what else would it be other than that? I mean, come on. Well, what else could it be?
Yeah, we're gonna go by the initials JD. But mm-hmm. like you can see the spelling. Tell me where mm-hmm. on the bottle. Special K said lower right.
Yes. It's down there. Well, it's right. Like I said, it is blurry and it's hard to see, but it's there. Special I can make the D out and the Z.
Okay. If anyone. Okay. Special K said, wow, star. Yep. I see JD. Okay. Let me look again. And I don't know. It's sideways, so if there's a way to rotate it, tell me that too. Because I'm sitting here mm-hmm. kind of sideways looking at it.
It's down there under the dosage information in the corner of the bottle on the right, bottom right, under dosage information in the corner of the bottle.
Okay, that is.
But I can make that. Out the D and the Z.
I'm going to make it less big.
Mm-hmm. And maybe it won't be as blurry.
Right. And then I'm going to do a screenshot. Mm-hmm. Screenshot. Did it work? Nope. Screenshot. Oops, that didn't work.
I don't know about amazing eyes, but I have a nice micro, you know, one of those, what do you call it? Where you can look through those. Thing, those round things, that magnifiers, man, blows everything up.
I'm trying to do a screenshot thing and it won't work. Hold on, maybe because I'm on the screen now. Come on.
No, I made out, I said, I made out the D and the Z, not J and D, but a D and a Z. I just couldn't make out the middle part, but that's the only thing that makes sense is deets. I mean, it just makes sense. It just does. What else would be a D and a Z? I mean, yeah. Mm-hmm. I can't.
Going with an issue.
Okay, because I couldn't hear you were roboting. Sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, because if I'm on the screen, then it's roboting.
Okay.
I think. And I keep trying to do a screenshot to make it bigger, but it's mm-hmm. that way I can make it expand it and it won't.
Yeah. You may not be able to do it while you're on here. You know, you may have to wait till you're off to really get in there. Yeah.
Yeah, because when I'm not on the screen, it doesn't seem to act right.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. No, it won't work. Okay. Dang it. Let's see. Mm-hmm. Where are you? There you are. Okay. Sorry about that. So, oh, good. Special K says, I will expand and resend. Oh, good. Thank you, thanks. Special K. Miss CD, Miss CD says, I screenshot that a long time ago. Huh. I see names in the chat that I've never seen here before. That's interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, by the way, how many of you had it? Go ahead. Sorry.
If anyone in the chat has been able to make that a bigger picture where you can see it, then definitely let us know in the chat because I don't know. I haven't seen it yet, but I'm not doubting it at all. Go ahead. Sorry about that.
Oh, I was just going to ask them how many, well, I was thinking about how many of y'all had a chance to go look at the thing on the Peterson, on the Lacey Peterson case, the information, because there's some stuff I didn't get to touch on last time. But when I said there were 7 women in that area that were missing, they were all pregnant women, by the way. And I forgot to mention that the dog search dog's name was Trimble, and that search dog failed 75% of the time on hits, so it wasn't really anything they could rely on. Another piece of information, when they went through, there was 80 to 100 boxes on just this case alone, and when they went through and was scanning this stuff, some of the pages stuck together. So the mail carrier that run that route, his statement, testimony, whatever you want to say, wasn't found out till 2 years later. And what he said was he delivered a package to to the Peterson's home. And he scanned, you have to scan those packages when you leave them, and it was put on the mailbox. And he noticed the gate was open and the dog was not barking. And he scanned that at a totally later time than what people were claiming earlier. And if you want to go by his information, Scott Peterson was at work during that time. Also, where her body was found, he was on the other side of the bay that day fishing and around the corner. He wasn't even in the area where her remains or a mile down where the baby was found. I just find all that stuff very interesting. Plus the fact that a lady drove by and seen these two to three guys that was in this van out in front of the house. I do think that they were robbing the house straight across from there. And another lady claims that she drove by and a dark headed woman that appeared to have on a white top and black pants and appeared to be pregnant. And they thought that she was squatting down peeing on, and they was letting her out, and they put her back in the van, that she got back in the van. This lady also gave that statement. And the thing that concerns me, when these guys were arrested for this, they claimed this happened on the 26th. Well, it didn't happen on the 26th of December. It happened on the 24th because the media was all around there filming all this stuff on the 26th early in the morning. And there was no safe that was took from this home sitting outside the yard. So those guys totally falsified their statements. I think what happened, I think Lacey Peterson was probably pretty spunky, and she probably approached those guys and said, "Hey, what are you doing?" You know, and she could see them, what they look like and everything. And I don't know, guys, I'm beginning to think that there is something else going on. You take seven pregnant women that's not been found, and this one lady that was found 6 months earlier, just her torso was left, just like with Lacey, in the same place, San Francisco Bay, but her baby was never found, and she was 8 months pregnant. And keep in mind, the lady I told you all about that had the dress shop, they followed her, and she was so scared she went in the back and locked herself in the back, called the police, and the one guy even come in her shop and left. They got scared and left because the police had been called. So those are kind of things that really stood out, other than the stuff that I mentioned about the reenactment of the boat, when the defense bought a boat and did the reenactment, and it would tip over, that there's no way those weights and that weight could be out there. They tried it four times and it tipped over. Also, people live there right on the, in the Bay Area there in their houseboats, and they seen him coming through there in that 14-foot aluminum boat with that motor on it. And they claim that you could literally look down in the boat, and this come from several people. It's in the statements and stuff. They seen nothing inside his boat that resembled a body that would have been wrapped in something or anything like that. They seen nothing in there. They said it was perfectly, you could see his feet and everything, and that they could see nothing in there but him. So these are some things that, and it does look like there's going to be a new case. There's some ladies that are really working hard on this, a group of women, and they've got a lot of information together. And the main thing that's going on this appeal, the first thing is because the inconsistencies in the jurors and stuff, and the judge would not, he excused anyone that said they were opposed to the death sentence. And you can't, for 60 years, they said that's been illegal, that a judge cannot excuse somebody just because they say that they're opposed to something, because the way it should be, he should have gone ahead and said, but if it comes to a decision and you find somebody guilty of something, is it possible you could come to the conclusion of imposing the death sentence? And that's the government 2 years later, just like the mail carrier. So, and he was well aware of this family. He was a regular carrier. So those are just some other points I wanted to bring out. But if y'all get the chance, go in there and watch this. It's very interesting. I heard a lot of things I've never heard before. So it's very interesting. And I'm curious to see what y'all think after you go and listen to the pros and cons on this, to what you come out with.
Well, I think so it's incredible that there were pregnant women who were murdered in that same area.
Right.
That's just incredible.
Mm-hmm. all of them pregnant, never been found. Baby's never been found. The one lady was even found, and she was 8 months along, and her body was in the same condition. I mean, yeah, that's really alarming to me. Yeah, it is.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't know half of this stuff. I mean, it's just, it's incredible what you find out. Things that were withheld and stuff. Can you imagine 100 boxes, going through 100 boxes of testimony and evidence? Wow. Yeah, so, I don't know.
Well, I just played with the pictures that Special K sent, and I was able to take a screenshot, and then I put it on another slide, and I made it really big. And I can't see it.
Okay.
And then I grabbed a pill bottle to compare, and I'm staring at this going, it should say provider in front of it, right?
Some of them do, some of them say physician.
And I don't see on this picture where it says that, where it says provider or physician.
Oh, that might be something else scary too. Who knows? You know, there's so many scary things about that case. You know, who knows? You know? I mean, even the spelling of the name and stuff, her name like that, that's wild. That's a different spelling totally, right?
And also, I want to know the date on that bottle, because she hadn't seen her doctor, right, since 2017.
Exactly. But so why would a lady, why would that lady even have anything to do with this, or even a, I don't understand a lot of things, but it's, it sure makes you wonder. And it's like that bottle that's in the office on that bookcase. It's turned the opposite way. There's no way you could ever blow it up and see, because it's turned away from the cam, you know, the police cam and all that stuff. But it was a pill bottle. Why would that be there on that bookcase? That was really a strange place for a pill bottle to be. So I don't know.
How did a woman have so many new prescriptions when she hadn't seen her doctor in so long, right?
I don't know. It's crazy. I know here you have to see a doctor to get, I mean, I have to at least go and see my primary care doctor twice a year to even get refills, even on blood pressure medicine or allergy medicine, anything like that. I mean, it's required. She has to see you at least twice a year.
And if she had lupus, fibro, and endo, and high risk, and blah, 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 she would have been seeing her doctor a heck of a lot more than
Once a year, on top of that, yes, exactly. And well, just I mean, we know she didn't have those problems because of her autopsy report said she was healthy, so that kind of blows that out of the water, doesn't it? That she had all those problems because there was nothing listed of any kind of damage to any organs. So I don't know, it's just it's almost impossible for somebody to have that many diseases and show nothing going on with the internal organs. I mean, it's just, I've researched that a lot, and they usually have problems with the kidneys, the liver, something shows up, you know.
Well, I wish we had a way of blowing that up and seeing, maybe one of the icky channels could get right on it and blow it up, you know, because they're always hard up for content. Maybe they could grab hold of the bottle, you know, the labels, and try to blow it up and see what it says, because man, that would be really good to be able to see it clearly. Right.
But there must be a little something to that. So, but why was NA so curious about those, getting in her purse and looking at those bottles? You know, she pointed that out. Well, her medicine is here, but supposedly she was taking, according to Chris, she was taking Imitrex too at that time for her migraines. So where was that prescription bottle? Because she was still having bad headaches and stuff. Why? So was she looking for another pill bottle? I mean, kind of makes you wonder, you know, what her interest was in digging around. I always thought maybe it might be a key or something, but I'm beginning to wonder now if it wasn't something else, a prescription bottle that she was looking for.
Well, isn't it kind of weird that in the next generation, I guess, doctors change their tune and don't mind pregnant women taking a bunch of terrible drugs?
Yeah.
Because back in the day, if you were pregnant, you didn't take any of that crap.
Well, any doctor that my daughter-in-laws and my daughter, any of them went to, they watched everything they took. They were very careful still. So that's why I don't think she was getting stuff. She was getting it, shouldn't have been, you know, wasn't getting it legitimately. Who knows, you know?
Why wasn't she seeing her doctor? What was she afraid of? Was she afraid of them testing her blood?
Well, yeah, maybe that. Or was she afraid that maybe finding that there was, her blood? What was her blood going to show? Was she doing other things, you know, using other medications? Was she, using alcohol? Who knows what she was doing? Because we did see her in several videos with drink, so we really don't know, do we? All that stuff sealed, so we don't have any idea. There's so much stuff that we've been deprived of seeing, and why, I don't know, you know.
And that label doesn't look like it's worn or old or tired, you know.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It looks like a fresh label. So why the heck is anyone prescribing anything for if she hasn't mm-hmm. been seeing her doctor?
Right. Well, they shouldn't have been.
Mm-hmm. Was she into alternative medicine? Right.
I've seen my nurse practitioners can sign for medications though on the doctor's pad, and their name goes on, but it goes under the doctor's dealer's number. I've had the nurse practitioners order my medicine, and they just use the prescription pad of the doctor's and send it in, but their name's actually on the bottle. So that's kind of, it'll say the prescription was sent in by blah, blah, blah doctor, but on the bottle it shows the nurse practitioner's name. So I'm wondering, you know.
Well, I
don't know. In a lot of videos, to me, she acted like she was messed up. Her eyes looked funny and her demeanor and stuff. I just don't know. It makes me wonder about that thing.
She shouldn't have been taking anything, right? I mean,
she shouldn't have.
And think about this, for her not to have seen her doctor at all, but yet they're all claiming 15 weeks pregnant, which I'm guessing is probably 12 to 13, if so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know? I think it makes sense that she would have been in to see her doctor immediately.
Well, it's like that container in the basement. Why was there a plastic container in the basement full of medication? See, we don't know. That disappeared. That should have been took in and looked at, but it wasn't, because once he pleaded, you know, and all that, you know, all that stuff stopped. So we'll never know what was in that container, because it's gone now, long gone.
Yeah, it makes you wonder, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. It does.
Especially if she's got old epinephrine pens and old nebulizer equipment and stuff like that. Like, yeah, where'd she get that stuff?
Mm-hmm. There was a lot of pill bottles in there too, though, according to that one lady that James, or that one cop said, look at all the pill bottles in there. So there was pill bottles too, you know. And what better place would there be to keep it than downstairs in the basement, where nobody would think to look for it, you know, or find it in a container, you know?
And where on earth would she have been? Well, it makes you wonder, mm-hmm. you know, because yeah. I know a lot of us have wondered for a long time what she was putting in those nebulizers. Where on earth? I don't understand how it can be that she can go on and on about all those fake diseases and go on and on as if she's surrounded by all those nurses, right? And then we found out a bunch of them were like caregivers or nurses' aides or whatever.
Well, I know she used oils on Bella because she said that she used a lavender oil on her stomach for a stomach ache, and it made her stomach ache go away. And I've never heard of using oil, rubbing an oil on a kid for that, ever. Even on an adult, I never heard of that, ever. It's just creepy.
What, she said that she put essential oils in the nebulizer?
No, she said she rubbed it on Bella's stomach when she complained of her stomach hurting. When she'd get up and said she has a stomach ache, she would rub the lavender oil on her stomach. But she said she used oils in the... she used all kinds of oils, you know, and she belonged to an essential oil group too, you know. That was one of the MLMs we found, where she was buying high quantities of that stuff. So she did use them. I don't know what all she used. But who knows what she put in there? I don't have any idea. You know, it's very possible. There's just a lot of things that concern me, you know, especially with the things in the autopsy that counted for like a chemical or a residue burn on her face. So makes you wonder. Really does. You can't, you just can't make that kind of stuff up. It is what it is. So. I just wish people would just tell the truth.
I just came back from my email. Thank you, Special K. Thank you. I just looked at those pictures. And yet, to me, it's all blurry. I'm not seeing it. But I'm not saying it's not there. I'm just saying I haven't seen it yet. So somehow we got to figure out how to be able to read it.
Okay, shrimp cocktails in the chat too right now.
Oh, she good, said, good.
And she said she did put essential oil. And, oh, she posted about putting it in the neb. Oh, she did? Oh.
And you know what? If you're going to put lavender or any of the other essential oils in a nebulizer, and then you surround yourself with people who call themselves nurses.
Yeah.
Oh, man. This case is so much dirtier than we knew.
Hey, I have a problem with you putting lavender oil on a child's stomach. Lavender oil, I've never heard of that in my life, and I've researched this and researched it. No place have I seen where that's okay to do that. You can take a bath in a little lavender oil or rose oil, but not rubbing it on your stomach. Yeah.
Just imagine if she's putting it in the nebulizer, those kids would have been in the emergency room. Remember how she said she had them? They had just gotten back from the emergency room the night before because they both had pneumonia.
Yeah.
You know, they both had pneumonia. They both had asthma. They both had all these things. And then they both had pictures of them sitting there, you know, inhaling who knows what. It's like that could seriously, physically, I mean,
bring on asthma and a lot of things. Yeah.
Yeah. And
breathing
all those
problems, people, pneumonia. Yep. Anything that's going to irritate the lungs, you know? Yeah.
All those people who are sitting there, what, looking at her posts, reading her posts, commenting on her posts, why the hell were those children in that home? Why? When you see two children sitting there with a nebulizer mask on, side by side, is there anybody at Child Protective Services who has a clue that two children typically don't both suffer from asthma attacks at the same time and don't both need to have a nebulizer treatment at the same time, right?
And they don't get tubes in their ears and their adenoids removed at the same time either.
They don't get pneumonia at the same time. They don't need prednisone and amoxicillin and lots of Tylenol at the same time, right?
Yeah.
It's just so weird to think that so many people.
But everybody wants to overlook that and say we make a big deal out of it. Well, it is a big deal because it's not right. This stuff is not right to do this under any circumstances. So why was she allowed to get away with this? With all these people around her that had all this medical knowledge, supposedly, and cared about these kids. Why did this happen? That's what I want to know. Why? You know?
Well, it's a sad day. Let me tell you, it's a sad day on the planet when two children's lives matter less than walking on eggshells around a nut job. Because if everyone was so afraid of Christopher Watts' wife that they were so afraid to speak up and say, no, don't give Bella and Cece Benadryl and Tylenol every night at 6:30 and then stuff them in their bedroom for 12 to 13 hours every night. Everyone was too afraid to say no to her.
Yeah, that's what I've said all along. Why didn't somebody stand? The people said they love those kids. Why didn't they stand up for those kids that they love so much? I just don't get it. I don't care how much they felt like they would make her mad. Who cares at that point? Who cares? If there's kids suffering at the hands of somebody that's doing stuff like that, who cares if it makes them mad? You want to just take them and get them out of that situation. I mean, this is crazy. It's just nuts. I just don't get it. And chocolate, they weren't allergic to chocolate. I've seen video after video, Bella eat brownies and eating chocolate chips, all kinds of stuff. That stuff is just you can just throw that stuff under the bus. I don't believe it, and it's just not, there's no proof of it. And the Thrive bars, they all, both ate those, and those have, were in places where there was tree nuts made and processed. So, come on. This doesn't make sense. It just doesn't. It's not us. We didn't do it. We didn't write about it. She did, you know?
It's so sad to think that poor little Bella evidently didn't matter to whoever, whatever, mm-hmm. however many people were, you know, watching and listening and reading about how Bella was in the emergency room. Bella was in for surgery. Bella was in mm-hmm. bed for 12 to 13 hours every night behind a locked bedroom door after she was dosed up with Benadryl and Tylenol. Did anybody care?
You know, I know a lot of people care? Give me the devil for saying that, that both families are to blame, but I'm and him, but I'm sorry. That's just the way I feel. I don't care how bad that it pissed her off. It's not right. Those kids were paying the price, and that's not right. They couldn't speak for themselves. All these people that loved her in these families should have protected those kids, period. That's just, well, it just makes, disgusts me.
What made Christopher Watt so weak of a person that he didn't stand up for Bella and Cece?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I just don't understand it. Their own father didn't stand up for him. I mean, come on. Yeah. That's just the way I feel about it. It just makes me sick thinking that all these people were walking on eggshells around her. Who cares? Those kids are not here now. And maybe they could have been saved. Maybe they'd be alive if somebody had stepped in and said, you can't do this. You're doing wrong. You're sick. You need help. You can't be doing this. You're abusing your children. You just can't do this kind of stuff.
Right.
Nope. Nobody did
right.
it. You know?
I think it's interesting that if it would have been Christopher Watts acting the way that his wife was acting.
Oh, yeah. They'd been on down on him. He'd been in jail and they'd thrown the keys away. Right. I mean, yeah.
And they would have said, oh, he's an abuser. Oh, he's a terrible abuser. Oh, look at that. He's using a rectal thermometer every single day. Oh, yeah. Look at that. He's a twink job or something. Right. If mm-hmm. because he's male, because of the whole ridiculous double standard that goes on, you know, the inequality between the genders that goes on, that if it's a man doing something, then watch out, he's an abuser, he's a child abuser. But boy, oh boy, if it's a woman, then oh, well, she's just strong-willed. Oh, she's just, you know, she just likes to have things in order. When she refused to let him leave the house, she refused to let him have any of his own money, right?
Yeah.
She used to let him go to the airport to take his friend to the airport. I mean, if that would have been roles reversed and it was a man saying, no, you can't go to the airport, you know, everyone would be going, oh, what an abuser, what an abuser. But no, because it's the mom, the Munchausen mom just gets a pass, it looks like, all the time. Well,
yeah.
That's BS. Bella deserved to be safe from a Munchausen mom.
Yeah.
And a Munchausen mom deserves to go to prison for many, yeah. many, many, many years.
Exactly. And there's a lot of them that do go to prison for many, many, many years, too.
Yeah, that one Julia's mom, she went for like 20 years, I think, mm-hmm. when she was making Julia sick. Look at what happened to Gypsy Rose's mom, right?
Yeah.
I mean, and which is terrible.
There's some other mothers that got 16 to 30 years for that, you know, for actually doing put stuff in the hospital. They got caught putting stuff in the...
Yeah, remember
in,
Lacey
injecting Spears? The bag, yes.
Remember
oh,
Lacey
God.
Spears and that little boy? Remember she
yes.
was putting salt? Yeah.
God,
you know,
yes.
I mean, this
horrible.
Is a very serious issue. Munchausen by proxy is a very serious form of child abuse.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't get it at all why people didn't care about Bella more than they cared about whether or not Nutjob was going to go ballistic on him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. And I do think that I do think CW was used to being, she manhandled him. I mean, she just did. She wore the pants in the family and whatever she told him to jump, he'd say how high. I mean, that's just, he even asked for God's sakes when she made those Thrive Bites, can I have one now? Who asked that? What man has to ask their wife, can I have a stupid cookie? A stupid bite of something.
And the Thrive Bites were like these little pockets of shit. I mean, there was nothing.
Size of a quarter, maybe. Yeah.
Not even that. Yeah, it was just this little nothing. Nothing. It was like an M&M of crap, you know?
Yep. I mean, it is what it is. And if people can look at all these videos and these lives and all this stuff and say they see nothing wrong, I question your line of thinking, seriously. I'm just saying I question your line of seriously question your line of thinking if you think that stuff is okay. Or, oh, well, that's just the way she did it. It's none of my business. Yeah, it is our business. It is your business to help protect children, because children cannot protect themselves. If you know of a situation and you're involved with those people, or you see this going on and you don't say something, you know, don't you feel a little responsible for them children not being here? I would feel horrible about it if I knew something like that and I didn't say something. I'm sorry, but that's just, I can't see it, you know. I just can't see concealing that stuff.
Well, and the whole free pass thing, too, for her to say some of the things that she said and to do some of the things that she did. Mm-hmm. You know, that loser video where she's going like, oh, he's a loser, or spraying water right in Bella's face, or any of it.
No, that's why we had kids. That's why we had kids, so we could do this. Yeah. Really? Okay.
Yeah, she was sitting there laughing while her poor daughter was being absolutely dehumanized.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all of that behavior
behind
was
the face. Yeah.
Overlooked, excused, laughed at, whatever. Mm-hmm. It's child abuse, you guys. It's child abuse. Why was it so obvious to so many of us to just watch a few of those videos that it was full-blown child abuse?
Yep.
But poor Bella had to live it day after day, year after year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, that whole rectal thermometer stuff, that should have had CPS at their door.
It should have. That should have been concerning, all the acting out that Bella was doing too on her toys and stuff. That should have been, and squatting over a water fountain. That all should have been very concerning to people when she videoed that stuff and videoed under taking pictures of her nephew's private parts in a pool. Come on now. This stuff, guys, it's just not excusable. You can't excuse that behavior for any reason. You just can't. It's not right. It's not normal. There's something wrong with somebody.
If it would have been Christopher Watts taking those pictures under the water of a child like that, man, he would be in prison. But, oh, it was her. So supposedly his sister just was so upset by the pictures, she deleted them quickly.
Mm-hmm.
What? Deleted those pictures? Really?
Yeah.
Nobody would have deleted those pictures if it would have been a man who took them.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So why the double standard? Are they so afraid of her erratic, abusive, out of control temper, whatever you want to call it? Were they so afraid of her that they thought it was just fine to let her get away with that?
Yeah.
You know, SA is a very serious crime. When you put all those, you know, connect those dots of the rectal thermometers, those little whistle thingies, whatever they were, the way that poor little Bella was trying to put stuff, you know, where, the way she took pictures of Bella trying to put stuff, you know, where, the way that she actually was at that, like, water park or whatever, where she was, you know, standing over that one fountain and stuff, and, oh boy, gotta have a picture of that and gotta post that.
But who takes pictures of that stuff, though? And their kids squatting over to get their temperature took and stuff. I just don't understand that, why people do that stuff. It just, I don't know. It just.
I don't think people do that. And I think that they should have had CPS at their door immediately. Yeah. Hey, Talisa, I don't know how to say your name. How you doing?
I'm great. It's Talisa.
Oh, Talisa? Hi.
Yeah. I've been studying the CPS thing on Shanann. I believe the kids were on an in-home chin. I believe they were, CPS was involved, and they were in an in-home chin, and her caretakers were limited on what they could do with the kids.
That's interesting.
Do you think that NA was one of the caregivers?
Yeah, I do.
Mm-hmm.
She knew way too. To not be her best friend, she knew about sex in the cabinet and all that. No one just tells people that.
Yeah.
Do you think that MA was the person who was there to drive the girls to the daycare center in the mornings?
I do, yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that's why she threw such a fit at like 9 a.m. because it was mentioned once in the discovery that the cops were called at 9 a.m., but they didn't respond.
Hmm. So that her sudden interest in the morning of where the heck was Christopher Watt's wife could have been because she was supposed to be taking Bella and Cece to daycare and she couldn't find them?
That's what I think.
Yeah. That's what I think, too.
So that might explain why there's so many cameras in the house, too. They were being, everything was being watched. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I kind of wonder how many people were drawing a paycheck out of that household.
Yeah. I think there's a lot of caregivers that were family members, too, supposedly.
I think a lot of people who called themselves nurses' aides who were getting a paycheck.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's like last night when you were mentioning the A word.
Yeah.
If you think about Shanann's autopsy, that would explain the blood loss, a botched A, and hemorrhaging.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Or it could have also, if it was like a partial botched, whatever, right? Mm-hmm. Or an incomplete.
Mm-hmm.
A week or two later, there could have been an infection from a botched A, and that infection could have been major issues, right? And there could have been additional bleeding and cramping. What was it she said when she was in North Carolina? Spotting and cramping?
Spotting, cramping, and vomiting, and dehydrated, and couldn't eat, all kinds of stuff, yeah. Bad headaches, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I do know when there is an in-home chins on kids, my best friend worked in foster care system for like 20 years. Babysitters have to be approved, background check. They go into your home periodically, day and night, checking the kids. Mm-hmm. But if they don't see any bruising on them, there's nothing much. Their hands are tied.
Well, but here's the thing, Talissa, here's the thing. If they had some sort of a protective care plan in place, I think they called it, referred to it as a family plan. You know, Weld County was known at the time of the tragedy, Weld County for quite a few years, I think 4 years or so before that, maybe even longer, was known as the model program in the state of Colorado for having the family plans where instead of removing children from the home, if it was necessary, if they deemed it was necessary to protect the child, they would. But they were the model program for the state of Colorado. They were winning awards for this model program to keep the children in the home under a family plan to take precautionary steps to try to protect the children. Okay. So if that's the case that the children were under a family plan at the time of the tragedy, then there had to have been an incident to have that family plan, you know, stemming from, right? And what we're told by people who claim to know and who sound pretty dang believable, if you ask me, is that there was an incident in December of 2016 involving medical child abuse. And that's where the problem is, in my opinion, because I think the standard reaction, you know, a caseworker is going to want to check the kids for bruises, make sure there's food in the fridge, make sure the house is clean, blah, blah, blah. But if we're talking Munchausen by proxy, if we're talking medical child abuse, is there proper training for the caseworkers, for the medical professionals, for the PAs, for the nurses, for the doctors, especially for the emergency room doctors, is there proper training for anyone who's coming in contact with poor little Bella and Cece, for them to recognize medical child. And in the event that there was medical child abuse, which took place and it can be substantiated, which what we're being told by people who sound like they know, and they sound pretty dang good, if you ask me, is that there was evidence to substantiate medical child abuse committed by Christopher Watt's wife. If that's the case, then my hunch is that would not be a case that is eligible for the children to remain in the home while they go under this family plan BS. I'm sorry. Medical child abuse is one of the most dangerous, possible forms of child abuse there is. And in my opinion, Bella and Cece should have been removed from that home. And if Christopher Watts wanted to hang out with his lovely wife and not choose his children over staying married to that, then they both should have lost any parental rights to Bella and Cece. Yeah. You know, if Christopher Watts had, remember how she said that when she spoke with him, that he said he was not going to lose the girls.
Yeah.
Christopher Watts was on his way out that door. They were getting divorced and he had his escape hatch open. And that's what instead of doinking his coworker for 5 weeks over the summer, he should have been climbing through that escape hatch with his daughters and made damn sure that his wife didn't have another chance to hurt those babies.
Right.
Now, my opinion is there when you go back to the safety plan, why do you think the in-laws sold everything they had and beat Colorado? Because they were part of the keeping the kids in the home. That's why when the mother-in-law got mad, went back to North Carolina, the kids went to daycare.
What'd you say, that the parents living there were part of keeping the kids in the home?
Yeah, because they sold everything but their house out of North Carolina and beat to Colorado.
Mm-hmm. Well,
and when the mother-in-law got mad and she went back to North Carolina, the kids went to daycare 9 hours a day.
Yeah, the only thing is that the people who claim to know, they say that the incident occurred in December of 2016. And Christopher Watts' mother and father-in-law lived there like a year by then.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So the incident there that they say happened at the hospital was in December of 2016, and I think his in-laws left like in February of 2017.
I don't know how long they lived with them.
I think it was like a, what was it, Sarah Mama? It was like a year, or a year and a half.
16 months, something like that, 16 months, I believe. From what I was told and what I've been able to find out, the first report to CPS was in 2016 from a doctor and nurse at a hospital that was concerned about all the trips to the emergency room and the oldest one not being having the problems that the mom was claiming. Okay, that's what I've always been aware of.
I thought that was 2016.
Hospital is mandated to report that multiple
times. That's when
trips.
Bella was 10 months old, I believe, right before she found out she was pregnant with Cece. Yeah.
That would have been 2014.
Okay. And it was looked into again in 2016. Maybe that's what it was. Yeah. But I know that it first started with Bella. It first started with her because there was a doctor and nurse was concerned about all the trips to the hospital. And they couldn't find things wrong that supposedly she was claiming was wrong. Yeah.
Yeah, that's where I've been told is that there was a case open when Bella was a baby.
Yeah.
And then in December of 2016, there was a case open that included both Bella and Cece.
Yeah, that was the one in 2016, too. You're right. Yeah. There was one before that and one in two. Yeah, that's right. I said the wrong year. It's the wrong one. You're right.
And then when that one was reported, this is, it makes sense if you look at things. It makes sense because all of a sudden these two kids are in daycare full time. Why were they in daycare full time anyway? Why would they be?
She couldn't be left with them alone, I think.
That's exactly what I think too. What do you think? Talissa about the possibility that it was that she couldn't be left alone with them, so they had to be in daycare full time. Oh, we lost she's Talissa.
Still... Oh. people just dropped. In chat were asking if the A could cause somebody to bleed out. Absolutely, it can cause you to bleed out if you research it. If women have been known to bleed to death from that. They sure have, especially on the back street ones. Yes.
Exactly. And it can also cause serious, serious infections.
Mm-hmm. Serious and it can also cause the fetus to remain in the system and can basically contaminate the mother's blood system too from the, because it, the fetus is not fast. So that can be too, you know.
She would have either had to got rid of it naturally or had a DNC at 15 weeks. Because my daughter miscarried at 14, and we had to take her in and get the DNC done. Yep,
sure do.
Well, and they would have gone
to bleed and blades, what it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they would have even did a burial.
Yeah.
They would have wanted to have had an ultrasound too to confirm what they would have called to confirm the A word, whether it was a miscarriage or an A.
Yeah.
They would. They would.
Oh yeah, my daughter had to have three.
Okay, we probably shouldn't be hearing all of that about your daughter. I think that the whole thing of the question of whether or not it could be a serious condition, a serious fatal condition, right? It could explain a lot of things, you guys. Yeah. It could explain a lot of things. If it's, if you know, all we have to do is back up to the charge code. Talissa, are you aware of the whole charge code thing about Christopher Watts?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's the, huge. Well, you know,
that
that's
a word.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Like, why was that ever even there, right? Mm-hmm. And then if you think about it, if this is the core issue of this case of confusion and chaos and why everyone's acting so squirrely, well, let's talk about it, you know? Let's pop this pimple. I mean, come on.
Mm-hmm.
This
exactly.
That sounds gross, but it's like, come on. There's something to discuss here. If there's a situation where there was that A thing going on, the A word.
Mm-hmm.
If that happened, we dang well should be discussing it because this is a public health issue. If there are people dispensing or prescribing or whatever or advising or blah blah blah, if there are people qualified or not, licensed or not, whatever, if there are people promoting all kind of back alley type behaviors, this needs to be exposed. It needs to be addressed. This is a public health issue. This is a women's health issue. Okay, and if there needs to be more education, if there needs to be more help available for people who are pregnant and in distress or whatever, this needs to be discussed. And if there's a man sitting in prison taking the heat for some A-word situation that he had nothing to do with, who is he protecting? What the hell?
Mm-hmm.
Who on earth in the right is encouraging a pregnant woman who's claiming to have lupus, fibromyalgia, endometriosis, was leaking store-bought
gluten intolerant, all that stuff.
Celiac disease. You know, she had every friggin' disease that, what was it, Jeremy Lindstrom, or I'm sorry, the Lindstroms.
Yeah.
About the, all she had to do was see the commercial.
See it on TV or a commercial and she'd come up with it. Yeah.
Yeah. And she'd claim that she had that new disease too. Okay. So if you've got a friend or if you've got whatever relative or friend, whatever, and she's claiming, you know, oh, hey, she's going to do a lupus fundraiser. Send cash to her. She'll make sure to give it to the Lupus Foundation. You know, how much BS do we have to see in this case before we call her out and say she was a liar? She was a fraud. She was a scam.
Mm-hmm.
And she was abusive toward Bella. Okay. Yeah. If this turns out that whole charge code thing and that whole evolution of events or whatever all was connected to some sort of an A word,
Mm-hmm.
Have we had enough of the chaos and confusion about this case?
Exactly.
Have we had it up to here? You know, we have had it. Mm-hmm. All these people trying to act like they are, you know, all concerned about, you know, a girlfriend, or all concerned about a cell tower. No, let's get right down to the nuts and bolts of this case.
Mm-hmm.
Why was he charged with the A word?
Mm-hmm. And charged for killing her two different ways. I mean, I didn't even know that was legal to charge somebody twice for killing one person two different ways. I mean, it's crazy. So
which is it? How did he supposedly kill her? You know, how did he supposedly kill her? By the A word, you know, resulting in her death? Or did he kill her, you know, by that whole fake strangulation because she was praying or something?
Yeah, she didn't have any marks on her. Yeah, right. None of the damage for that. Yeah, right. Mm.
Exactly. So, you know, it's time for us to, I think, discuss the A word big time. Mm-hmm. Because if she had an A word, then
but she had that prolapsed uterus too, you know. So that's
if she had the A word, then we want to discuss it. Mm-hmm. Because this is an issue that affects all women. We do not want to stand back while our medical profession and our legal profession both would just kind of go, I wonder what happened. No, if she suffered death as a result of a botched A word, then we should be discussing this, right along with the fact that poor little Bella suffered child abuse.
Mm-hmm.
One thing that gets me is the sonogram doctor contacted the police, and they never followed through to see what was so important that the sonogram doctor wanted to tell them.
Are we sure that they never followed through, or is it that it wasn't included in discovery?
I had the first discovery a long time ago and read it, and they never, they said by the time they got to it, the link had expired.
Wow.
Right, that's right. Who was it that was up on panel telling us that the link that they were provided didn't work?
Yeah, I've heard that a lot. Absolutely, I have. Mm-hmm. And there's stuff that's missing from the original discovery too.
Oh yeah. The more I've read the discovery, the more questions I have. Like, why were the girls described wearing three different outfits at the time of the? They found them. The cops tell you one thing, the coroner tells you another, but then Tammy Lee and them say something else.
Yeah, and yet he didn't know what the pajamas looked like either. That was crazy. And what happened to the clothes that they had on the birthday party? They just disappeared. Nobody said anything about them, you know?
Yeah, when the police took them out of the tank, supposedly, they had on collared shirts and shorts. The coroner said Bella had on onesie and underwear.
Yeah.
Tammy Lee said she had on a pink nightgown with, I think, a
hearts
unicorn.
And flowers or hearts and something on it. Yeah. Unicorn.
Yeah.
And hearts, something like that. Yeah.
Now we see Shanann's bra and underwear, but we never see the girls' clothing and why.
Yeah, we don't. And also, one of them was in a pull up, remember? Yeah. That was too. Which one wore a pull up? She said Cece. Then they said, well, we found Cece. And there's something else I want to know. Have y'all noticed that at the cemetery on their date of death is all August the 13th? Well, I thought that a coroner I thought they didn't do a date of death until the body had been recovered and a coroner pronounced that person dead. Then they go by that date, no matter.
Yeah, with when, the 16th,
yeah, but their
16th,
date of
16th.
Death. Well, their date is all down. It's August the 13th. So I don't know how they arrived at that. I really don't. But every one of them's date of death is August the 13th. I just found that out today. I couldn't believe it. It just doesn't make sense.
So what are you saying, Sarah Mama? You're saying that the medical examiner should have said the date of death when he proclaimed?
When they actually recovered the bodies. And he pronounced him dead. Yes. That's the way it goes all the time here. I mean, people can be missing for a long time, but once the body's recovered, it's when the coroner determines that they're officially dead and what caused the death. That's when they determine the time of death. That's the date of death, what they put on the death certificate. Right. This is automatically the August the 13th and all these, you know, and I don't get it.
Don't forget to, they were identified over the phone, right?
Yeah. Well, their bodies weren't recovered on the 13th. So how can you put them down as deceased on the 13th? None of them were found on the 13th.
Yeah, that's a good point. So they hadn't determined.
They didn't even know if they were dead, supposedly. So what right did they have to put August the 13th, 2018 is all on state of death? I just seen that today and I've got, this doesn't make sense because they weren't even found.
Oh, wait. Their bodies weren't even recovered. Wait. You're not talking about a death certificate, then you're talking about the headstone?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
they got it down as August the 13th, but their bodies weren't found on August the 13th. So how can you determine that?
They can put whatever they want on the headstones.
Really?
They paid for it.
You can't. Really? Wow. Yeah. Here you can't. You have to go according to what the coroner puts down as a date of death. You can't do that.
I thought you were talking about the death certificate. I'm like, what?
Oh, I don't know. Hey, I have no idea what that. Well, no, there's different dates on the death certificates because their bodies were found at different times. Her body was found different time. And then the girls, one was found one day and one was found the next day. And she was found, remember? And one was found one day and they were all found on different days.
So were their death certificates different then?
I don't know. I'm going to have to go back and look at that now. This is more red flags that's been raised to me just about a couple hours ago. I thought,
the headstone stuff doesn't matter. They can tell them to carve whatever they want into those headstones.
Yeah. That's why Shanann was buried as a Ruzak and not a Watts.
Look what Special K put in. Look down there what she found happened in 1978, three women in Colorado killed there by poisoning their livers by drinking aromatherapy oil. Oh, wow.
Oh my God.
There you go. Interesting, huh? Wow.
I do wonder,
I was going to ask this girl, what do you think about the connection with N.A.'s son knowing so much about that house and so much information, the police knowing, you remember me? Yeah, I remember you. You know,
I think that that is where N.A. worked, and I think that he probably was one to spend more time out of school than in school. I don't know.
I think he calmed her down, too.
With him being 16, I mean, he could have been out corning and the cops caught him and that's how they knew him.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean he's a criminal. He could have just been doing stupid kid stuff.
I think he was in some kind of program or something that one of those cops was over. I read a little bit about that, but that doesn't account for him knowing the upstairs and the color of the sheets and
He spent a lot of time over there.
Yeah.
If he spent a lot of time over there, then he would.
Well, if you think about it, if mom's working, they went out for, a week on North Carolina. Maybe he's the one that took care of Dieter and just wandered around their house.
Yeah.
Well, no, because Christopher Watts was still living there.
Oh, Tennyson said in the chat that their death certificate dates were odd. I bet it is. I bet they are odd.
I mean, that week Chris went to North Carolina with Shanann, hell, he could have been the one watching the dogs.
Oh, that's true. But he knew what kind of sheets they had. He knew everything. He felt very comfortable. I think it appeared. He had it. The phone number for Christopher Watts' wife was listed on the phone as mom's work.
Yeah.
I think he spent a lot of time there.
Yeah, I mean, she did have strong legs. Ask her dad.
Yeah, that does. Oh, you mean as far as him helping MA keep her under control?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And she did say, and I did say something about him helping her when Christopher Watts' wife was upset or whatever, right?
Yeah, he said that. She said that he could calm her down. Her son could calm her down. Yeah.
I really think Shanann was bipolar. If you watch her videos,
Yeah.
She's happy and go lucky. And then when something don't work right, look at her like whole expression change, even towards Bella.
Mm-hmm. Well, she even talks about how she was less weird, less moody, less whatever, you know, mm-hmm. supposedly with her juju juice.
A better mom and a better wife and all that. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
And then all that crap, how she was supposedly up at 4 a.m. cleaning closets. Yeah. Yeah, if she ever cleaned anything, I'd be surprised.
And then she was going to have to play mommy for the day to go to the zoo with her two out-of-control children.
Exactly.
She play mommy. Yeah, I bet she did have to play mommy.
Exactly.
Huh. Yeah, it's just too weird.
What's funny is any woman that's had her nails done knows if you're doing that much cleaning, that pedicure is only going to last, or manicure, for a week.
Yep.
Once your
hands get cleaner,
dishwater, dishwater, whatever, that manicure is gone.
Well, you got to keep in mind, Chris did most, CW did most of the stuff. You know, his mom even said that. I mean, she even said he did the laundry and the dishes and a lot of the stuff around there, you know. She did say that. Cleaned the carpets and a lot of stuff. So I don't even know how much she really did do. Truthfully.
I don't think she did anything at all.
Truthfully, with CW, I think the house was so clean because that's the only thing he could control in his life.
Yeah. He couldn't even check his own mail when she was in North Carolina either. Remember, he couldn't even check his mail. His own mail for 6 weeks, for God's sake. What is that telling you? Somebody was controlling something that wasn't him. It was not him.
She was hiding the bill.
Yeah, or somebody was hiding plenty of stuff along with her.
I didn't think she was controlling the money either. I think there was somebody else who was connected to the whole caregiver routine who had control over their money and who was robbing them blind.
Yeah.
I think they were being robbed blind. I don't think Christopher Watts' wife had the IQ or the math ability, whatever, to handle any of it. When she said that she mailed that HOA payment to the wrong address for 30 months straight, I think she meant it. I think she didn't have a clue even what the HOA was or how much it cost or anything. I think somebody else was handling their finances.
Intercepted and didn't mail those checks in. Yeah.
I think somebody else was in control of their finances, and I think Christopher Watts trusted whoever that person was, and I think whoever it was robbing him blind.
Yeah, I think those checks never made it, and they never cleared the bank, but the money was gone. So what does that tell you? Somebody got a hold of that money.
It went somewhere.
It sure did. And I bet you that she was on getting disability checks all her life, and somebody was in charge of that. Probably getting disability checks on the kids too. Truth be known.
Exactly. That's my opinion.
I really believe it. I honestly do.
There was big money flying into that household from the government. Mm-hmm. And I think that there were other people besides Christopher Watts or his wife handling the budget. And I think that whoever had access to controlling those finances, I think, just my opinion, that they kept a lot of secrets from Christopher Watts. And I think that the whole thing about all that MLM bullshit, it was all a scam. I think the whole thing about lupus was a scam. I think the whole thing about fibromyalgia was a scam. Mm-hmm. All of it, a scam.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, sure do.
So just think about this, you guys. Christopher Watts is getting a divorce. Christopher Watts is moving on with his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Christopher Watts is done. Done taking it. Done being everyone's doormat. He's done.
Yeah.
He and the girls were ready to go get the hell away from Crazyville. So guess what that means? That means that any money train was about to be derailed, right?
Right. Yeah.
Well, we could give our honest opinion on this show without getting attacked.
As long as you use initials and not names.
Yes.
Okay. Here's my thought. When they first met, SW didn't like CW. But when she ran his credit at Dirty South, she fell in love with him. That's my opinion.
Exactly right. Exactly right. It was love It was love at first sight of running his credit report is exactly right.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. Because he was a skater boy. He wasn't her type.
Yeah.
As soon as she saw that credit report, it was, oh, sugar daddy.
Yep.
I think that she looked him up, I think, as soon as she found out he was a master mechanic. And I actually think he was exactly her type because he needed to find, she needed to find somebody doofus enough to not be able to recognize immediately that she was a scammer.
Mm-hmm.
And let's be honest, I think the first piece of butt Chris got, he married, and that was Shanann. Mm-hmm.
No, that's not true. He had a couple of girlfriends before her.
Yeah.
And he had good friends. He had a couple of good women that he dated long before she came along. And he was functioning. He had a good social network. He had hobbies. He had, you know, a good job. He had a good savings account. He had his own home. He was not the you know, poor little whatever that was wowed by some big city chick or whatever. She was a loser. A loser.
Mm-hmm. And I tell you, one of my biggest pet fucking
he's the one who had the friends. She didn't have friends when they met. Nope. He's the one who included her in his network of friends. And she was a social outcast. She couldn't handle being with his friends. She didn't even know how to go to their house and have an evening. Like, she was insulting them, insulting their dishes, insulting their houses. She was absolutely a social outcast. Mm-hmm. He would show up the next day and apologize to his friends for how bad she was acting.
Well, she even said that she couldn't keep friends because she was sick all the time and stuff. And she worked all the time. And nobody, you know, she was considered an outcast if you look way back when she talked about her life and stuff.
The only thing about that statement would be that she couldn't keep any friends, but I highly doubt she worked all the time, and I highly doubt she was.
I'm just telling you what she said, though. You know.
Yeah, but no, he was a functioning. He was 25 years old. He had a good savings account. She was fortunate that he even bothered to date her, and I think that he was just doofus enough for her to be able to pull her scam.
Yeah.
Right.
You think that she was stable? I kind of think that at one time he thought she was financially stable, maybe because of that house. What do you think before he found out the real truth around it? That house.
No, I think he would have looked at that house and thought, what the heck? Who would want this place?
Yeah. Well, right. He paid for it for a while, didn't he?
Oh, I bet he paid for it from the day they met. Mm-hmm. And
she quit her job, remember, 3 weeks afterwards, right? Yeah.
Oh, if she ever had one. If she ever had one. But her mother, I think, was using that as her address at the time, too, wasn't she? I can't remember. One of her relatives was living right in the house, and then some other couple was living there also. You know, he was probably sitting there going, what the hell is this? All these people in and out. What's going on?
Maybe she was getting a little bit of money on him to pay whatever needed to be paid, you know?
She probably, we've talked about it before, whether or not she may have been pregnant when they first met.
Yes, I'm sure of that too. Yeah. I think she was pregnant several times.
One thing that's always pissed me off about Sandy, the mother-in-law, is the way that 10-letter page was attacking Cindy. Cindy's kids were successes. Her kids, what the hell, has anyone seen a diploma from either one of them?
Nope. Have not.
You
can't find them.
Cindy and Ronnie raised college-educated children.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell did they raise?
I find it really disturbing that at a time of a family tragedy where you have a woman and two children who are dead, that it seems really strange to me, not just one person, not just two people, but like, how many? Seven or eight people? Boom, 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 boom. Right on down the line, they were all wanting the police to know that Cindy didn't go to the wedding.
Yeah.
Like what? Why would anyone care whether or not Cindy went to a wedding 5.5 years before two children were murdered?
You know, she rent all the food.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, well, fucking really.
Cindy sent me pictures of the food that she and Jamie prepared for that pre-wedding party. There was plenty of food there for the person lying about whether or not she could eat gluten, you know?
Well, it sure is strange that some of her favorite recipes that her mom puts on there has noodles and stuff in them, isn't it?
For somebody with gluten intolerance. Yeah, stuff that I could say, put that on there. Her daughter's favorite recipe was nothing but gluten, right? And oh, boo-hoo. But, you know, 5.5 years later, after Cindy doesn't go to the wedding, then Cindy's any of the bad guys because supposedly they had gluten food, you know, at the party. Mm-hmm. No, they showed me Cindy sent me the pictures of the food they prepared. There was plenty of food for, you know, Miss Prissy Lupus, whatever, to eat.
She probably just didn't like what they fixed. It probably wasn't up to her standard of what she wanted.
The bigger question is, if you have two dead children, why the hell does anyone care about whether or not there was gluten in the food 5.5 years earlier?
Yeah, like, it doesn't, because they had to do something to discredit and to make Cindy Watts look bad. That's what I think. They were doing it and to make him look guilty and his mom look bad. Yep.
Well, that's the hard part.
Let's be honest.
Why were so many people attacking Cindy? Why?
Right. And let's be honest, we're all moms here.
Yeah.
You're going to go on a damn trip to Aspen, but you can't afford the butter on your damn bread?
Yeah.
Now, come on. Who's going to do that? A nut. That's who.
Well, she was delusional at that point.
Yeah, I think she'd done lost touch of reality. Yeah, there's no way they could afford to go to Aspen for that trip because they were flat busted. They didn't have anything. They were losing their home and everything. Yeah.
That house
she couldn't afford a trip around the block.
Mm-mm. Nope.
Well, and she didn't have to worry about taking a trip around the block because she just put her tennis shoes on and said, take my picture so it can look like I'm going for a run. Mm-hmm. That's who we're talking about.
You mean her flip-flops?
Yeah. Well, she would get her running shoes on and have her picture taken and have it look like she was going for a run, but then she wouldn't go for a run.
Yeah.
But she had the picture, the photo op, right?
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah. But remember, she always, her favorite pair of shoes was by the front door. She wore them all the time. And if you look at most pictures, she had those flip-flops on. I'm telling you, that was her main pair of shoes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I don't think she's allowed to have shoes with shoestrings in them myself. Because the kids didn't even have shoestrings in theirs.
I personally think it's likely that she spent the majority of her time in a room on the main floor away from everybody. I think when she had the videos going, if she was bipolar, if she was manic depressive, if she was whatever she was, I think when the videos were going, she was on her up phase or her up moments. And that was her up moment, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think she was crashing and burning in the room on the main floor.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, even like the Thanksgiving video, she's all happy and she's baking, but as soon as she sees that mad face, her demeanor changed like snapping your fingers.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah, we never seen that prime rib for New Year's or Christmas finished product either. We never seen most of the stuff that was finished. That's what
exactly.
I mean, yeah.
And even when the girls were making cookies with her, when the girls stopped whining, her demeanor changed like snapping fingers.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah, she had to leave them in the refrigerator for 3 to 4 hours. I've never heard of that where you could bake cookies. Never heard of it. Never.
Exactly.
And how many times did she sit in the driveway and do videos? I'm telling you, she didn't drive any place with them kids. She never showed them going to Walmart, Kmart, going to Target, going to the grocery store, nothing. No videos at all about any of that stuff. She even said she went and picked grocery orders up. I'm sure somebody else did, not her. Or she had stuff delivered. I just don't think she was, because he had to take off work when the kids were sick and stay home. So she couldn't be alone with them. It's obvious they couldn't go to school. So they were home and she couldn't be with them. It's just obvious. And people think this isn't important. To me, it's very important because everybody knew. And those kids, it just didn't matter. They were just stepping on quietly around her, not to set her off. Man, who cares when she's abusing those kids?
I think there are three big issues with this case myself. I think one, of course, is the medical child abuse. It is seeming to, I think a lot of us more and more, that it was obvious as soon as we saw any of those videos of her talking. I think the poor little girls were being abused medically. And I think that we need to do something in the way of promoting awareness for the medical profession, or making sure that medical providers and CPS workers are trained and coached and encouraged to notice medical, you know, Munchausen by proxy, because these little girls like Bella and Cece, they can't verbalize. They don't know. To them, medical child abuse is normal. It was normal for them to be dosed up with Benadryl and Tylenol. You know, they wouldn't have known to have told a youth worker about that. The other thing that I think is really important is that I think that Christopher Watts was a battered husband. And I think that it is time for family centers, for the women's shelters, for the women's centers to be changed to become family shelters. Because I think men need to have a place where they can go for counseling, where they can go to learn how to get their voice back, how to be able to say, I am going to go to the airport with or without your permission, bitch. And guess what? This marriage is over because I've been here for 5.5 years and I'm done taking your shit. You can be sane or you can be crazy, but I'm out of here and I'm taking our children with me because you are an abuser.
They're not safe around you.
Exactly. Exactly. Christopher Watts lost his voice somewhere along the way.
He did.
And I think it had to do initially with the whole, I think she was quite a bit older than he was, and I think she was dirty, and I think that he was naive. I think he trusted people. He was an honest person, and he expected other people to be honest in return. I think, you know, he probably started to lose his voice when she beat the crap out of him and shoved him physically out the front door and locked the door and had him standing out in the winter weather without his cell phone or his keys.
Yeah.
His voice along the way. I think Christopher Watts was clearly a battered husband, and that's an issue that we need to help promote awareness about, because
it isn't just women, men are abused too. That's where
it just isn't right that because he's male that everyone is saying, oh well, she was just a strong-willed woman. No, she was abusive toward her husband, she was abusive toward her children, and it, you know, that's in my opinion. But you want to know something? It doesn't take a rocket scientist to watch her videos and to see it clearly how poorly she treated her husband and how poorly she treated her children. The third thing, the third thing about this case that I think is so important is the behaviors paralleling our discussion on this case, the abuses that go on, the abuse and harassment, the threats, the stalking, the BS that has gone on trying to silence us from being able to discuss this case. No true crime case ever before the case of Christopher Watts has there ever been a gang of thugs
and
trying
haters.
To harass, abuse, and threaten and frighten a bunch
and
of
going real life on people and going real life. Yeah,
exactly. Placing our lives in danger, placing themselves really at risk of prosecution, at risk of civil liability also. And you know what? They don't care. You want to know why? Because in front of them, they play psychos who don't have any assets, knowing damn well the little games they play. And then they watch their psychos dance. And then they get up there every once in a while and say, oh, yeah, you know, I mean, little ones here, the tag team over here, and then the other team over here. And then they start fighting among each other and whatever. Parallel to this disgusting case of Christopher Watts, parallel to that is the disgusting exhibition of a bunch of psychos thinking that they have the right to attack innocent people on social media who are discussing the case of Christopher Watts. So, I mean, I think those are the three main issues. I think the thugs need to pick up their toys and go find a different sandbox to play in.
I think too. Mm-hmm.
I think the issue of medical child abuse needs to be front and center. And we need to be sure that the medical professionals are getting the proper training, that the CPS workers are getting the proper training to become more aware of the risks to children if there is medical child abuse going on. And I think the entire issue of the male victim of domestic violence needs to be discussed out in the open. And again, we don't need to have women's centers in this country.
We need to have family centers. Yeah.
Family centers in this country so that men with small children actually feel that they do have resources available to them in the event they're married to a Shanann Watts. That's just my opinion.
Well, and I do think Bella was talking. I think she was telling people what was going on, and that was bothering SW severely. I really do think that.
But I mean, let's be honest here. She's a mirror image of her mother.
Who?
Shanann.
Oh, yeah.
I don't understand why somebody would... I'm sorry. I'm going to go ahead and... make an executive decision there. I don't understand why somebody would hop up on somebody's panel. I don't know. I'm not gonna comment. I just commented by making my executive decision.
About what? Oh.
Yeah, I mean, I guess opinions are welcome, that's true. But yeah, you know, I follow my gut feeling on this kind of thing, so I just followed my gut. So anyway, what song would you like, Star Mama?
Oh, shoot. I guess our theme song. We don't hear it enough, you know? Yeah.
Oh. Or, I got it. Okay.
Mm-hmm. We don't hear it enough, yeah. And you got an early day tomorrow, I think, too, don't you?
Yeah, we'll go ahead and say goodnight. I will.
Yeah, because it's pretty good.
Your theme song and click. And thank
you. If y'all get a chance, go research the Lacey Peterson case a little bit. I think you'll be astonished at some of the stuff that I found. I mean, yeah, it's just crazy.
Okay, so thank you so much for hopping right up, Sarah Mama. Can you hear me or no?
Okay. Yeah, I can hear you. You're roboting a little bit, but I hear you. Every thanks. Good night, Bobs. Good night, MMM, and I'll talk to you later. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. All right. Okay. Good night.
Don't tie me down, 'cause I'd never stay.